Welcome back to our lecture series in DC machines and transformers. So in today's class, we are discussing about winding diagrams. So before going into the details of winding diagram, you have to brush up all the things that we already covered in armature winding. So if you didn't watch our previous video of armature winding, you please watch that video in detail about front pitch, back pitch, pole pitch, all those things, and then you may understand this topic very well. Actually, we are going to draw the entire winding diagram of a machine. Suppose if you are a workman who is assembling a DC machine, before designing the entire thing, you have to calculate how many slots you need, which passion, lap passion or wave passion, how many conductors you want to implement, because you may have some idea you should get some 400 volt or 300 volt, so that from each coil how many volts you will get, how many series connection you need, how many parallel connection you need, how many parallel paths you need, all those things you should calculate. So then only you have to decide how many conductors you need. Then you have to think how many slots you need to accompany, to allocate or to accommodate these conductors, like that. So in our question, you don't have to go to such a level of calculation, because voltage and such things, they already calculated. They are just telling you to make a winding diagram, so that you have to place, you have to accommodate enough number of conductors in 20 slots. And they have decided that you should have to follow simplex lap winding. All those things are given in the question. Normally, you people have to follow such questions only. You don't have to calculate number of slots or number of coils from voltage. You have to do only preparation of a winding diagram from the given data. So from this question, first of all, in this area, there is two windings in your syllabus, simplex lap winding and simplex wave winding. Duplex wave or triplex wave, such things will not be asked for university exams, because it takes a lot of time to complete the drawing. So simplex lap and simplex wave, these are the two things we need to follow, we need to learn in winding diagrams. Simplex lap and simplex wave. First of all, in this problem, we are covering simplex lap winding. They already given, assume single turn coil with two conductors per slot. So before going into the general rules of armature winding, let me brush up the things. Actually, this is a lap connected system, because suppose this is a north pole and this is the corresponding south pole. We know it is lap because this is the first coil which I have drawn by using green ink. Okay. So this is the first coil, its beginning end and finishing end of first coil. Then the second coil is connected in the same north pole. This is second coil. The pink color one is second coil. This is connected in the same north pole. So it is lap winding. If it is wave winding, we have to go to next north pole like this. The finishing end of first coil is connected to beginning end of second coil under next north pole. Then it is wave winding. So this is a lap winding case, where we can see How many conductors under each pole? There is 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 conductors under each pole. Again 5, 6, 7, 8. Next 4 conductors under next first south pole. So there is 8 conductors. So let me ask one question. How many coils are there? How many coils are there? 4 coils, because one starting end and one finishing end contribute 1 coil. Okay, and you can see it is a single 10 coil. If it is multi 10 coil, it will repeat some more turns before going into the commutator, but each coil is going into the commutator, so it is a single 10 coil. Now let me ask one more thing. What is front pitch? What is back pitch? Okay, before going into that, I will tell you how many slots we need for accompanying these 8 conductors. This is a question that I am asking you. How many slots we need? We can use 8 slot. This is one option. This is one option. 8 slot means each conductor is placed on separate slots. We can use 8 slots. But it is not that much common in DC generator or DC motor system. Generally, we are using 2-layer winding. If we are using 8 slots for 8 conductor, it is a single layer winding. But now I am telling you that generally we are using 2-layer winding. 2-layer winding means in each slot we can place 2 turns or 2 conductors. In each slot we can place 2 conductors, one upper conductor and one lower conductor, so that we can reduce the number of slots. It is very economical also. So 2-layer winding is generally used so that 2 conductors may be grouped into a single slot. So you have to think that how many slots we need for accompanying these 8 conductors. In 2-layer winding we need only 4 slots to accompany 8 conductors. Okay, so in this question they specified that it is a 2-layer winding because 2 conductor per slot. Turn is something different. Single turn, 2 turn is something different, that I will come into that. But it is very specified, 2 conductors per slot. So it is a 2-layer winding. Okay. So we can tell we need only 4 slots for 8 conductors. So in this case, I am specifying that in this case of 2-layer winding, we can tell that number of coils is equal to 2 into number of conductors. This is correct for all type of winding, but specifically in this case number of coils is equal to number of slots, because in each slot there is 2 conductor and 2 conductor will contribute 1 coil, like that. So in case of 2-layer winding, number of coils is equal to number of slots. In case of single layer winding, number of slot is equal to 2 into number of coils. In case of 2-layer winding, number of slots is equal to number of coils. So it is clear, I think. So this is also an important thing for 2-layer winding. or 2 conductor per slot winding. Number of coils is clear. Now let me ask you, what about commutator segments? What about commutator segments? We can see this is the first coil, and that coil connected to first commutator segment. And from what that commutator segment, we are starting another coil. We are starting another coil, and that is connected to second commutator segment. And from that same second commutator segment, we are starting third coil, and third coil get finished, and that is connected to third commutator segment. From the third, we are starting fourth coil, and that is getting finished, and that is connected to fourth. Normally from the fourth we will start the next one, that is another case. Anyhow, we can see here we are having four coils and four commutator segments. Okay, so as we concluded, number of commutator segments is equal to number of coils. In the last board we discussed that very well. So this is applicable for all the cases. Number of commutator segments is equal to number of coils. So now, as of now, we discussed the number of commutator segments, number of coils, number of slots, such things in terms of single layer winding and two layer winding. So in this problem we are choosing a two layer winding or two conductors per slot. Now what is single turn coil? A single turn coil is just like this. This is a single turn coil. This is starting end, this is finishing end. One coil is full. Then it is connected to commutator. Then we are starting the second coil. Then we are starting the second coil. This is a single turn coil. If it is a two turn coil, it will be looking like this. Actually one coil, one turn is over, but it will not go to the commutator. It will again make one more turn and then it will go to the commutator. Then how the second coil will start? The second coil will start from this point and it will also make two turns. It will also make two turns and then only it will go to the commutator. So this is the case of single turn and two turn. On other words, we can classify this as simplex or duplex. Simplex or duplex. And what is the difference between simplex and duplex? What is the difference between simplex and duplex? Its main difference is number of parallel path. Generally in lap winding, we know number of parallel path is equal to number of poles in case of simplex winding. In case of duplex winding, number of parallel path is equal to 2 into poles. Generally number of parallel path is equal to, in case of lap, it is A is equal to M into poles, where M is plex, duplex, simplex. If duplex it is 2, if triplex it is 3, like that. In case of wave winding, the same thing, number of parallel path was generally A is equal to 2 for simplex. If it is duplex, A is equal to 2 into 2 for duplex, and generally A is equal to M into 2, where M is equal to plex. This is the conclusion of wave winding. So these are the things. Now I am moving into the front pitch and back pitch. So our winding in this problem, our question comes under two layer winding, where two conductors are placed in slot and it is simplex winding like this. Number of parallel path is equal to number of poles, and these two things are already discussed. Now what is front pitch, back pitch, such things? This is a two turn, sorry, this is two individual coils. What is back pitch? Back pitch is distance from starting end to finishing end of a single coil, starting distance between starting end to finishing end of a single coil. It may be generally specified by number of slots or number of conductors. We can specify it by number of slots or number of conductors. In our problem, we can check. We will while doing problem, we will you will get a clear idea how we can specify whether it is using number of slot or number of conductor. That we will discuss. And what is back pitch? Back pitch is the distance between finishing end of first coil and beginning end of second coil. This is back pitch. Distance between finishing end of first coil, sorry, not back pitch, I am sorry. This is front pitch. Finishing end of first coil and beginning end of second coil. This is known as front pitch. So back pitch and front pitch are already discussed. Now we will move into the problem.